Oh, I would like to say something about Moscato. You know why? Because, like I said in the beginning, Spinetta is very famous for of course, Barbaresco and Barolo, but I don't want to forget to forget we started with Moscato, okay? And Moscato is something very important for Piemont, something very unique. And Spinetta was one of the first great Moscato producer to be able to export this wine, okay? We started with the United States, nobody was talking about Moscato, and Spinetta, he was there, Moscato Spinetta was there, and in China, and Japan, everywhere, okay? In Germany, of course, in Italy, but no problem. But you know, it's very important for us. I don't want to forget this wine, because it's so important, not just for us, for Spinetta, because we don't have enough production to supply the market, but it's so important for Piemont to be able to be proud about this wine like this. Wine like this is so special because it has, if you have a glass of Moscato in your hand, you smell, you are here, you are in Santo Stefano Belbo, you are in Canelli, you are there, you are completely there, you are involved in this thing, you have this kind of pleasure to have this kind of fruit in your glass, and the taste, and the alcohol is so low, and it's something you can enjoy like aperitif, it's something you can enjoy with the dessert, it's something you can enjoy with friend. You don't tell, if you have a Moscato glass, a bottle in the fridge, somebody's come to your house, they don't tell you before, what they want to open, wow. Bottle of Moscato, you make everybody happy. Everybody happy, somebody want to have great wine, big wine, somebody, okay, a lot, okay. Moscato in the past, talking about the past, I took about maybe 50, maybe more than 100 years ago. It was the wine for the lady, you know. They all opened this wine because it's so easy, so sweet to understand. And it's part of Piemont mentality, part of Piemont production. It's part of it. And Moscato does, especially Moscato does. And we were born with Moscato. I will never forget that. I will pay a lot of attention. We have spent this a lot of time in the vineyard, in the cellar with Moscato, like we do this for Barolo, Barbaresco, because for us so important. The first vintage was 1977, Moscato, and we started with Bianco Spino and Brico Quaglia. It means two different single vineyards. Bianco Spino is a little bit more, it's talk about southeast exposure, sandy soil. It's a little bit more approachable, more easy. This is why we are delivering this wine in the before Christmas. And Brico Quaglia, we are delivering the wine after Christmas, okay, in January, because it has different complexity, it has different power too, because we talk about southwest exposure vineyard and calcareous soil. This is a different thing. But really, Moscato is so important, not just for Spinetta, so important for this area. I remember in the past, a lot of good restaurants in Italy. I took about Lorenzo, I took about Romano, I took about so many, okay, of course, in Piemont, so many other restaurants. They used to do Moscato included with the dessert. When the people, the customer, they were ordering, okay, they want to have dessert, glass of Moscato was there. It was there because something unique, something special, Moscato d'Asti. I said before, acidity, minerality, and complexity, and sweetness. It's fantastic balance. It's fantastic balance. And our Moscatos, okay, Bianco Spino or Brico Quaglia, they have there inside. You can taste this. We are so proud because all the people, they taste Moscato. Oh, I don't want to have Moscato. When they taste our Moscato, oh, wow, Moscato could be so good. It could be so good. And in the last 20 years, a lot of great producers, more producers here, they do beautiful job. And Moscato now is something special. Moscato d'Asti is something special. And I really want to enjoy with you one glass of Moscato because for me, it's breakfast wine. And I want to tell you this funny story about Moscato. Maybe you know, maybe not, but you know. Great friend of us, of my father, was making Moscato. My father wasn't making Moscato at the time. And this old man used to have two two sons. They were the same age. And we went, okay, every summer, we were stealing Moscato from him. Really, with a little bit of straw like that, okay, tube. We were going in the cellar and we were drinking. I was 6-7 years old, okay. We were drinking, we were tasting Moscato from there. It was something unbelievable, you know. This is history. And my mom used to do special thing for us when I was young, when I was okay, 6-7 years old. My mom used to do special Moscato soup in the summer. It was good because we had 3 boys and 1 girl, but it was not easy for her to control us. And at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, she used to do the Moscato soup. It means, okay, half Moscato, the alcohol very low, okay, water and the bread. He used to give to us this thing. It was so good, cold, but it was also good for my mom because after that we took a nap. It was good. This is Moscato. Moscato is a big part of our culture here, of our culture, and we are trying to do the best with Moscato. And now the vines are very old. We talk about, okay, Bianco Spino, the average of the vines, they are 30, 35 years old. Brico Quaglia even older, it means 40, 45 years old. And the only big problem about Moscato, we don't have enough production. We don't have enough. Now, I think this year we'll be sold out in, I don't know, 1 month, but it's very important for us to be able to give something original, something very true, something people they can taste and say, okay, we are in Piemont. We are in Piemont, not with Nebbiolo, not with Barbaresco, not with Barolo, but with Moscato. Something unique. When you smell Moscato, good Moscato, it's like, you know, I'm the one who's taking care of the harvest. It means, okay, I'm deciding in Piemont, in Tuscany, with my brother Bruno, which is the best time to harvest. I'm going around in the vineyard, I'm tasting, I'm checking the sugar level, okay, I'm tasting. When I smell this Moscato, I have the same feeling, the same idea, the same thing when I'm tasting the fruit from the grapes in the vineyard before the harvest. It's maintaining the same thing. It's sweet, but it's not too sweet. It has good acidity, it's great minerality. It's not just about Moscato nose, it has also mint, he has, oh my God, it has honey too, you know? It's something you can enjoy by himself like this, or you can enjoy with so many different kind of dessert, but you don't need to match this Moscato with big dessert chocolate. No, it's something light, something easy. Think about strawberry, you know? Strawberry, now with the season, strawberry or peaches is perfect to do peaches soup with some peaches and Moscato. It's something unbelievable, something unique from Piemonte.